Hey guys, welcome back to our channel. If you haven't already, make sure you subscribe and hit that bell to turn on post notification. Please also give this video a thumbs up if you like it. It really helps. Today we're going to talk to you about a question that we've gotten hundreds of times over the last couple of years. And that question is, do you want to have kids? So let's get started. So I feel like we've had the conversation about kids since the very beginning of our relationship, maybe even to the point where it was a little premature of us to talk about it, because we started talking about kids within the first couple of weeks.
I think it was like a month into our relationship. We weren't even official yet.
Yeah.
And we were picking out our kids' names. And fun fact, we have had the same name picked out since we talked 9 years ago in the beginning of our relationship. So we won't reveal that just yet, but we're very excited about it.
But let's get to the topic of whether or not we want to have kids. So the answer to that is yes.
100% yes.
We definitely want kids. We actually, I had a goal in life that I wanted to have kids by the time I was 30. Mm-hmm. I'm 32 now, I'll be 33 in May. So I feel like the clock is ticking. I definitely want to have kids before I get too old, because I want to be able to feel like I can run around and enjoy doing those fun father things. So
I don't think you'll ever have a problem with that. I don't know if you guys are aware or not, but PJ has a ton of energy all the time, so I don't think you have to worry about that.
Well, we'll see. So I had an initial goal of having kids by the age of 30, but then we got the TV pilot that we filmed for HGTV, which from start to finish took up 2 years. And because of that, we weren't able to focus on that. Then after we finished the show, then kind of social media blew up and we did a lot of travel trips, and I think the travel trips are the main concern as far as bringing kids into the picture now, because we do travel so much, it would be hard to do that. We actually, maybe, was it last year?
Mm-hmm.
That we were very serious about having kids. This was before the travel trips picked up. We actually signed up to start doing a course so that we could do foster to adopt through the state of Tennessee.
And we also talked to a couple of different surrogacy agencies. We got accepted into some adoption programs. We didn't discuss that at the time because we just didn't feel like it was the right time to share it.
Yeah, it was. I think we were both wanting to enjoy going through the steps before sharing that, but because you guys ask, we want to share that part of our life because we feel like we're at a point in our life that we're ready to share that, because we are firm believers in putting something out into the universe. And I feel like we maybe weren't ready to put it out in the universe, because if something were to happen, I don't know that we were 100% at the moment, but now I feel like we are 100% ready for kids. Whether that happens next week or next year, I think we're in the mindset within the next, for sure, next 2 years that we would like for it to happen with. Go ahead. What were
you gonna say? Well, I was going to say, realistically, if it was up to us, we would have had a kid like yesterday.
Yeah.
If it was as easy as
that. Yeah, it's just not easy. It's expensive and it is not easy. It does take a lot of planning. So though we're ready for kids now and would obviously love the chance to adopt a kid tomorrow, I feel like the process is going to take some time for us. To mix in the traveling that we will be doing over the next year will also slow things down a bit. But I think foster to adopt is an option. I think adoption is an option.
Surrogate, we would be open to surrogacy.
Yeah.
So really, I think that the main goal is to just get a child. And we are open to all avenues. And, you know, the cool thing is we, like PJ mentioned last year, we weren't really ready to share that with everyone just yet. But I think that over time we've realized that, you know, we do have this platform here on Instagram and YouTube and social media. And a lot of you guys have questions about kids and, you know, you're interested in having them too.
But also a lot of you guys have went through the steps that we are about to start going through. So we felt like putting it out there, you could answer some of our questions, but also for those of you that are in the same position as us, you can kind of follow along as we go through the steps of being able to either adopt a child or doing surrogacy and going that route. I think we would both love that. I would love to see a little baby Thomas running around, and I feel like that would be such an enjoyable experience, but I also feel like there's tons of kids out there that need to be adopted, so we're open to that too.
I think ideally we would do a little bit of everything. I think ideally we would like to have one, you know, with a little baby PJ, a little baby Thomas, and then we would love to adopt and even foster to adopt. So
yeah.
We kind of differ on this. I want a big family, and I think PJ would be okay with a bigger family too. But I mean, I think the end goal is just to have kids and just be a family.
Yeah, I think I've always wanted kids. I feel like you've always wanted kids. Yeah. I went through a phase in my mid-20s where I was hesitant on kids because my mom had my little sister Montana when I was 20. So I kind of got to see Montana grow up. And I feel like that did put kids more on the back burner for me, experiencing that and seeing how much work it was, but also, you know, a lot of different factors in that. But I am in a place where I feel like financially we're in a good place for kids. I feel like we have a great house to raise kids in. We don't even use half of it. Like, you guys see that we're downstairs the most. We have 3 bedrooms upstairs that we don't ever touch.
And that's another thing that we've talked about is I would love to bring kids home to this house because this was the house that I was raised in, that I was born in, grew up in, and I think it would be just so sweet to make new memories of kids of our own in this house and have them enjoy it the same way that I did.
Yeah. I feel like we pretty much covered the topic of kids. So, you know that we are in a state of mind that we are open to kids if the right situation presented itself. We're, I think, probably going to restart the process of doing the course that we would have to take in order to foster to adopt. We'll look into that for this year. And also probably surrogacy and then maybe even adoption through an agency. Or a private adoption, but we've done lots of research. We've got prices for all of those. The prices are crazy. obviously, fostering through the state and adopting through the state would be the cheapest route.
Yeah.
And then adopting through an agency is like $30,000. And then doing surrogacy could be anywhere from like $60,000 to $200,000, $300,000. It just depends on what you do and who you go to do it. It's a crazy range. We've talked to multiple people that have actually went through surrogacy. Yeah. We know that that may be an option, but adoption may be an option, and then fostering to adopt may be an option. But and maybe even just, I would be open to just foster care in general because there's so many kids that, I used to work for the state of Tennessee in Child Protective Services. There's so many kids that come into foster care situations, and I would even be open to that.
Yeah,
even
me
if it
too.
Was temporary or permanent, but just being able to help. Yeah, so that's that. We're going to have tons of questions. So if you guys have actually went through the process, we would love to hear from you about what you did, whether it was adoption or surrogacy or foster to adopt. You can leave a comment down below and tell us what it is. Maybe we'll reach out to you and ask you questions about it. We did some conference calls with some people that did surrogacy and some people that adopted and had people come over and talk to us about it. So we're super excited about the process. I think we're both ready for something to, you know, our first stepping stone was kind of gathering information, and now I think we're ready to move past that.
I am so excited. I know PJ is so excited, but also we're just excited to bring you guys along on this journey and take you along with us. So we can't wait to get started.
Like always, you guys can find us on Instagram at PJ and Thomas.
You can find us on Facebook as PJ and Thomas and on Twitter as PJ and Thomas.
That concludes our video about kids. We hope to take you guys along on the adventure. We know it's gonna be a long one, but feel free to share any of the knowledge that you have by either going through the process or knowing somebody that did. You can leave it down below in the comments. Until next time.
Bye, y'all.
Bye, guys.